looking dangerous too.
Flick of the elbow from Novak. That is time to go for Tadej. Pogacar pounces on Lara Dutz.
Well, Pogacar has not even waited for the steepest slopes of this climb to put his attack in. They go past the grandstand here. The road sweeps around to the left, sweeps back to the right, and it really ramps up in excess of 20%.
Carapaz gets across.
So he's the only rider who's been able to make the distance. You can see the chase there by Lutsenko from Astana out of the saddle, looking pretty controlled, and on his wheel, Jai Hindley.
There's 500 metres to go. 500 metres of suffering for Carapaz, 500 metres of opportunity for Pogacar.
Oh, Carapaz digging really deep there, trying to minimise his losses to that Pogacar. But as the road ramps up, he's going to have to work hard.
Here comes Bernal. He's not out of it. So Pogacar has not put them all to the sword. Egan Bernal is rising from the ashes of a horrible crash a couple of years ago.
Oh, Carapaz there looking over his shoulder, seeing how big a gap it is back to the group. He cannot no longer match the pace of Pogacar.
Mathieu van der Poel is in that group and not out of it.
So you could see it didn't look like he'd done a lot of damage, but he stayed in the saddle the entire time, and other riders, as they accelerate, then they start to lose distance. And now look at the gap opening up.
34 kilometres remaining in the race, only 170 metres to the summit of this climb. Tadej Pogacar has accelerated away now, very much in control.
And now Pogacar has the throttle fully open. It's Poggy go time.
Well, quick look over his shoulder there. He can see he's established quite a good gap. Takes that sharp corner to the right now. Now he's opening up the burners.
And his bike handling skills are exceptional.
Now, Tadej Pogacar is going to be looking ahead, looking to that red lead car, following his lines through the corner. So I think this is a new section to the parkour. Normally at the top of the Côte de la Redoute there, you would take a left. But this year, they went hard right. All very matter-of-fact there coming for the team car of UAE Team Emirates. Just getting some information across to Tadej Pogacar. What's the gap back to the chase group? How many riders back there?
And as you can see by the graphic on the bottom right-hand corner, he hits the base of the climb, having raced already for 231 kilometres. This is Bardet. He was third in this race in 2018. Bob Jungels was the winner that year. He's coping well with the conditions, so far at least. Oh, this is biblical rain that they're now dealing with. This can really change the dynamics in the race, certainly for the minor placings. Yes. As the weather deteriorates, the advantage for Pogacar grows. This is the bonus part of the climb, and the spectators know that it is brutal. They're even climbing up on the signpost to get a better view.
Yeah, this is a tough section of the race. Once you've got all the categorised climbs behind you, you think you've got the hardest pace part done. However, then they throw this climb in as well.
Still plenty of power going through the pedals, but the shoulders look even more relaxed now.
Race time there, 6 hours and 12 minutes. Incredible difficult conditions today. Cold, rain, over 4,000 metres of climbing.
He's still dancing on the pedals, just cruising across the line. Now we see a smile for the first time.
It's been a big performance by the team. They have dominated the race, took control with more than 150 kilometres to go. Time and time again on each of the climbs, it was his compatriot Domen Novak who turned the screws and weakened the legs of the rest. It was then on the Lara Dutz, where it was Pogacar who pounced. And Tornado Tadej goes out the winner of the 110th edition of Liège-Bastogne-Liège. There's a big story in this. And here's a look at the top 10 behind him. Bardet in second spot, Van der Poel in third. An extraordinary podium, the top three, as you'd expect from a race like Liège-Bastogne-Liège. The brilliance of Tadej Pogacar reigned supreme today. He made